Will there be a great housing market financial crash in 2021? And I think the conclusion that I finally came to is going to surprise you after we dive into all of the data points. I was surprised. I think you're going to be surprised. And there will certainly be a crisis, just not the crisis you thought it was going to be. Well, Johnny Bravo, please, I am limited on time. Tell me now. Okay, I'll tell you right now what I think, and then we'll go into the housing market. Is number one, highly potential humanitarian crisis underway that we have never seen before. And I believe homelessness will increase like we have never seen before. And I believe that there will be a continued exodus, right? That was a good book, right? Exodus from the cities to the suburbs. But the big question is, will there be a housing market crash? Well, I'm going to explain it to you in three easy, simple, fast steps. And let me go ahead and get out my whiteboard. I honest God, shout out to George, great guy. I just don't, the learning styles, the whole whiteboard thing, this is what it looks like to me. I don't know. And I honest to God, I searched supply and demand housing market. This is what I got. So I'm going to explain to you in three. It's like a pachinko ball. Actually, whiteboard videos look more like this to me, right? They're like, okay, so on the left is you see the labor market, and then to the right, you can see that. And I'm just like, can you stop? Remember, I have two brain cells. That's it. It all just is Greek and Hebrew to me. So let me explain. First fundamental, you have supply and you have demand. And right now, these are the indicators we look at when it comes to, is there going to be a housing market crash? And if it meets all of these variables, oh, well, you're going to have a crash. But if it doesn't, well, that means we're not going to have a crash. So the first one we're going to look at is supply and demand. And I'm going to tell you right now, there is no supply and a huge amount of demand. So based on that scenario, there isn't a market crash that will happen, but we have lots of scenarios. I'm sorry, we have lots of key data points or data points that we need to look at to see if we met the criteria. So once again, we're in, here in California, we're back in lockdowns again. There is no, and people don't want to put their houses on the market. So there's no inventory. So we still have a demand, which is pushing prices up, and that is going to continue. Well, we'll move on to point number two. Is, are people putting their houses on the market or are they taking them off the market? Now, if they're putting them on the market, oh, crash be a coming. But as you see this chart to my that way, I don't know, because when I film, even when I point, I have to point in the opposite direction that I see. So everything's bass-ackwards over here. So home delistings have been and are on the rise. Plus, as you can see here, that's what's happening. People are pulling it off. They also like to show a house, the amount of like things that you got to go through. And then with the winter months, right? New lockdowns. Inventory is not going to be on the market except for when there is foreclosures or evictions or delinquencies or banks and their lending standards. Or you're like, what are we rowing here, Johnny Bravo? We are rowing a boat, and that is with an oar. Also, so this is what is going to be happening, not happening right now. So it's causing prices to go up. And I believe you're going to continue to see that until this slew of the foreclosures hit the market come January. We'll see how much the government will allow and how they can kind of like, it's like a fire hose, right? Restricting it. It's like, how much do you want to let out? Because you got to be careful how much comes onto the market. That will definitely crash the market. So many people think that it's going to be like 08, but there's so many differences between now and 08. Take, for example, lending standards. You have the banks, and they are, what are they doing? They're restricting. They're not lending. They haven't been lending for 6 months, 8 months, a year. So you don't have all of these people like you had back in the day that they did the liar loans. I remember in 07, 08, I think I bought, I had purchased a townhome. Craziest thing. I bought a townhome. And I'm like, okay, so how much do you want me to put down? They're like, eh, it's fine. Nothing. Well, I also have VA. But they just went based on my FICO score. Like, really? I'm like, how much? Well, how much do you say you make? Okay, I make a bazillion. Okay, that's fine. Here you go. Here's your loan. And we don't have all of those people with the liar loans, with high interest rates, or with adjustables that could possibly go up. Now, I don't see that happening. I could be on the wrong side of the fence, but here's how markets work. You have bonds, and the bonds control the interest rates, and then the Fed chases that. And they're like, oh, look, ha-ha, we're chasing you. We're in charge here, but they're actually really not. But that is for a whole nother topic. Right now, the banks aren't lending. They're restricting. They're restricting credit, causing a recession and a depression, because how money and how economies are economies is because of the banks. That's where money comes from, is banks loan. And the banks have not been loaning, even with these ridiculously low interest rates. I mean, this is historical. Not just that, the bond prices are historical. We're talking like the biggest ever. So bonds go up, rates go down. And I've showed you this. If you're like, where do I buy said bonds? Well, you can do it the good old fashioned way, or you can just buy TLT. Not financial advice. I don't know what I'm talking about. You lose all your money. But like this right here. And this, I'm a swing trader. Bonds, you know, it goes up, down, goes over that 200. Bond prices are going to go in that direction. And look, looky there, Stephen Van Meter's going to have his day in the sun in about, you guys want to know what percentage he's away from? Because dudes like to measure. He is 1.25% away from a rocket ship takeoff in the bond market, causing the, here's the yields, to go down. See the inverse? This is the 30-year Treasury bond yield moving in that direction, making your interest rates go lower. And I think that that's going to be for a while. I also offer a course on this if you want to learn how to trade anything from, I don't know, TLT to Alibaba to, let's see, what's been going on? Oh, Bitcoin. Yeah, I don't know about that one. Apple. Which one are we going to look at? Apple, you would have made. One of my students is like, so let me just pick a stock. How much would I have made? I had to like calculate 21%, 20% flat, 7%, 2%, 13%. Just based on my indicators, just based on what I teach you in the course, it's very much, I'd say you learn about 80%. If I had to throw, you know, some shat on the wall and go, that's about it. And that's what you need to know to make money. But anyways, the course is 1,000. I bring it all the way down to 290-something dollars. That's for a coupon code down below. But if it's gone, that means it's gone. The price of the course will go from 297 to 397 to 497. So I'm just saying, you may want to get it now if you want to learn how to trade. If not, it's okay. But Johnny Bravo, Apple isn't part of the housing market. Okay, TREX. This is a good one to follow. Hey, there it is. And right when it crosses that little white line, which you learn about in the course, and everyone's like, wait, people are going to need to start fixing up their houses. Just on this from the bottom, because I like to be a narcissist and pick at the very bottom to the very top, that is a 186.63 gain. And so you know what we do as swing traders in the housing market? We swing. So when it swings down, which you can clearly see, look at the swing, swings down, up, sell, another swing down, up, buy, and then you put in a buy. And just to let you know, you would have, did you guys see that big long candle with the teeny little wick? You wouldn't have caught that, Robin Hood kids. That's after hours trades. And guess what happened? It broke that little white line that I scream at you. You break that 200-day moving average. Goodbye. So you had to be actually following that in after hours trades, which you do on Webull, which they give you 3 free stocks. I think they're doing some kind of promotion right now. They give you even more. I don't know. Just take a look at it. Link in the description if you want. If not, I get it. But at some point, right, we make it back above that line. No more trading, Bravo. I just want to know, is my house going to crash? Well, back to the supply and demand. If you think that the amount of foreclosures and the amount of people getting kicked out, booted out, is going to exceed the amount of demand from people with money, and I am telling you There is so much money on the side that has been on the side. Just talk to Warren for a long time, waiting for deals that when those houses come on the market in January, February, March, and it starts to weed out and it start, you know, people start buying and putting renters in there and there's going to be a demand for that. Will you be right or wrong? I think this is just in my humble opinion that there will be still more demand for all of those homes that come on the market that will probably stabilize the price. And also, housing markets, number one, there's no such thing as a housing market. It's more like housing markets. What are you looking like in New York looks a lot different than Idaho, looks a lot different than Montana, because everyone's actually leaving California to go to Texas, from New York to go into anywhere, actually go anywhere out of California, you're better. Nevada, and then you don't have to pay state tax, save yourself 13, 14, 100%, you know, if this ball continues to roll the way I think it will. But all markets are different. They don't just come to a crashing halt, right? Especially not the way it's set up currently. Now, housing market update. Here we go. Home buying picks up after election week, pending sales up 30%. I rounded 30%. That's huge. That's huge. And home prices rose 15%. And new listings were up just 7%. You see, the supply and demand causing prices to continue to rise. And the people, we'll call them the have-nots, you're starting to see that and a whole lot more between the haves and the have-nots. Also known as the rich. The rich get poor and the poor get poor. The rich get poor. Yeah. It's just the way this is set up. This, see the cheddar right here? This fake stuff, fake belief. People believe this is money. It's not money. It's just currency, just debt units. The whole system's based on debt. It's Keynesian. It's just debt. There's no even such thing as money unless you have gold, or if some of you guys want to say Bitcoin, then yeah, there you go. That could be money, or whatever you think is money. Seashells. And then when people say, oh, I don't believe in that anymore, which I don't think that's the case, but it's okay. You can still have gold. There's a demand for this. Anyways, the rich demand for what? Second homes. Oh, because the rich continue to get rich. Actually, it surged 1%. If you add zeros to the end, 100% year over year. So the rich are just, oh my gosh, what do we do? Well, let's buy a second house and a third house and a 15th house. And this is what's going to lead me until my final port. That's like after 12 o'clock at night, gentlemen. Oh, I'm just going to go watch some port. The number of people locking in mortgage rates. You're like, why does it have to be after 12? For second homes has jumped as remote work enabled affluent Americans to escape city life during the and at the same time, millions of families are suffering as businesses shutter and unemployment looks like that. And it actually does kind of reminds me of my situation. I do own a home. I do have rental property. I've been doing this for a very long time, ever since Robert Kiyosaki told me to buy rental properties. I'm like, okay, Robert, I'll do what you say. And then he said, make sure you stick renters in there. I said, okay, check. I've been doing that since the 2000s, a long time. I've owned houses in Texas and I put renters in there. In California, put renters in there. And it wasn't until Stephen Van Meter said, what are you doing, man? Because I'm waiting for the influx of properties to come on, buy homes, put renters in there. And he's like, that's so much work. Why don't you just keep trading equities like you're doing? And I'm like, that's a great idea. Steven made me do a paradigm shift in my head going, wait, this is actually one of my properties in Texas turned into a crack house. Yep. I got a phone call. They're like, howdy. I'm like, hello? They're like, your house. Blah, blah, blah. It's a crack. The DEA or whatever. They're kicking down the door today. And I'm like, what are you talking? I don't even, what? Because I live in Southern California. I forget my rental properties. And that's what happened. And then that's a headache, right? I'm like, yes, Steven, you're right. I can make more money trading equities. He's like, light bulb moment. Just that darn Robert Kiyosaki. beat that in my head. Passive income. Gotta have passive income. But with passive income comes problems. But it was a goal of mine, so I will buy minimum one rental property this year, one rental property next year. Hopefully they just won't turn into crack houses. And with interest rates so low, what? I have to. This is crazy. You can buy, take a house, $100,000 home, whatever, $200,000 home at 2.5%. $100,000, what is it? What's your monthly payment? Like $250, $300, $400, $500, $600. That's absurd. And here's another point you need to understand. People don't buy homes.
Yes, they do, Johnny Bravo.
No, they don't. They don't buy homes. They actually buy a payment. So that's what they do. They go, what can I afford? They buy a payment. They don't buy a home. Same thing with a car. Well, what's my monthly payment? People go into, and they're like, what can you afford? Like, that's what used car dealerships, right? Car dealers, they're like, what can you afford? Well, I can afford this. That's how it is for a home. What can I afford? I don't care about the price of the house. Just what can I afford? And right now, the afford is cheaper than anything. And in my opinion, it's going to get cheaper. Maybe the price might go up, but interest rates, could be wrong. But I believe bond prices up, rates down. And how do I know this? It's because banks are restricting. They're not loaning. So rates can only go down. Fed's upset about that too. Mnuchin Smoochie and the Fed, they got in a fight recently. And lending standards are ridiculous. I mean, even for me, I have phenomenal credit. I don't really need the credit, but I have great credit, like 830, eight something like that, really high. And when I bought my wife's car and I didn't pay it off, then they wanted me to put a down payment. I've never in my whole life. And I'm like, I'm old. I have really good credit. And they're like, nope, you need to come to, you know, a down payment. I'm like, really? So the big picture, is there going to be a housing market crash? I don't think there's going to be a crash. I think there's going to be bumps, right? Because I don't think there's like a specific quick direction. You can see it in the housing market. It's not like, oh, didn't see that one coming. You could see it. You could get out. You could sell. So no crash. But there's a bigger problem. And it's what I've talked about on this channel for a long time. It is the wealth inequality that is happening because of this. This is going to create a possible civil war. This, you're seeing it. You are seeing a divergence, a separation of America from the haves to the have-nots. Is it going to get better? No. Will it matter who you elect? No. It is just the system that is in play when you have 100 musical chairs, but you remove 5 every single year. Okay, you could say that. How many years has it been? You could see since what, 1900, and then we had 1913, 1914, and then 1944. We had this became the standard. This is it. Everyone use this now. And then 1971, and we had it backed with gold. My gold is now missing. And then they unpegged it. Everything went to the shat hole. And now we have inflation. We also have deflation. It just depends on where you're currently located. But if you are currently located in a home, you might be homeless. It just depends. Where are you at on that scale of rich to poor? You need to be moving up in a direction of rich. Otherwise, you're going to get knocked out. See, the homelessness is just exponentially growing. And I see it here because I'm on the West Coast. So it's treacherous. So we have a gigantic humanitarian problem now, and it's going to get worse because we also don't have the law to enforce it. I'm going to do a video on that, on just out here in Los Angeles, everything that's been defunded. It's like a lot of my friends, because I worked law enforcement, and they're like, yeah, we can't stop for that. They can do that. I'm like, wait, so I could do that? He's like, yeah, you actually can and get away with it. I'm like, you're kidding me. I can do the hit and run thing. And I mean, don't quote me on this. I'm going to just show you what the truth is. And then you're going to yell at me. Why would you tell people that? Then they're going to go do it. All right. sorry. I think the people on this channel are not those people. We, you guys are smart. You guys are really, really, you guys are way smarter than me. Way to go. I appreciate that. Wish you guys were all in here. You can be like, Johnny Bravo, you're, that's incorrect. But also, I have people like Doug Casey coming on Tuesday to talk about that, the separation and the Civil War and how bad he sees it getting and how bad it's going to get and what's going to happen. That's where I'm concerned. Like the housing crisis, all right, not so much. What's happening in this nation? Well, it's something that you need to pray for. Ah, that was stupid. Pray for? Like, let's just destroy this whole thing. That's a great, good prayer, Johnny Bravo. No, a prayer that it won't happen, that this will all get fixed, and I don't have a solution. Actually, I don't, isn't that crazy? I'm like, I don't have a solution. The only solutions that I have is, prayer, start businesses, let's see, trade equities. And I don't even think, you know, like Dave Ramsey, the Ramsarians out there, they're like, you got to cut back. You got to just spend less. I don't think that's the solution. I think you need to make a truckload more, like, for example, I'm looking, oh, let's play the game. What the frack is my wife looking at? Recently viewed. Oh man, I even know. If you don't know this, see this little bar right there? See that? That's Tom Ford. Oh gosh. I'm going to have to click. Is it? See if I'm right. Oop. Do I know it or do I know it? How much are those? $249. But us dudes know what to say when your wife tries on a pair of $249 glasses. You're like, oh, those kind of make you look fat. And here's something crazy. I bet you that you could make more money on a phone, right? Doesn't that solve a problem? Then you could just, whatever, go move. That's what I'm trying to do. Go give me a lake. Let me chill. Let me trade. I can trade. I can still do my businesses. I can still do you guys. That was inappropriate. I can't. That's gross. I would bet there. Okay. Yeah. Tom makes $8,000 a month. That's it on selling that sunglass. That's the cool thing about Amazon. You don't even have to be a brand. You could just be one of these guys selling like what do we got? We got. Wow, son. Wow, son. For men and women. There it is. So you could do that. What's this guy making? I'll tell you, they just manufactured in China. You can't do it in the United States because it would cost you too much and no one would buy it. Sorry, you guys, that I would love to. I would love to. So this guy, just on that shade, makes $72,000 a month. Selling his wow shade. And what you can do, also I have always use the coupon too. Click that, save $4. My wife's like, oh, I didn't notice that. I'm like, great, thanks. I do have a course on this, link in the description. That one's 198, that one is going up. I think you got a week left until it goes up, it'll be 300. What I like to do is cherry pick. Oh, look at that, you stud. I like to cherry pick to see like what else they sell. And then I copy that too. And since you stay to the end, I'll just show you. I just typed in fart. Fart machine, fart gun. They really have a fart gun? Is that really a thing? A fart gun. Huh. I like that. I'm going to buy me one of those. Ooh, that's a big blaster fart 9000. Look at that. It's an air bazooka. Okay. And this is what if you guys only knew my products. Here we go. How much is this guy making? Sorry. And then I'll go into his other stuff that he sells. Because a lot of times it's not the same kind of brand. Oh, my God. Oh, this guy makes $23,000 a month. Probably has no competition. Look at that. No competition. Ew. Oh, gosh. I don't even get it. I don't know what. Pull straight back. Release. Okay. You can catch it. I don't even know what it is. But what I'll do is squirrel products is I'll go here. They have, they're branded. So I can't really see. Here's some of the other things. See, they sell this, they sell that. How much are they making on Mickey? Probably not much. Monkey headband. And you could have these things done for nothing. Just nothing. Takes too long to refresh. Yeah. Broken. All right. But I'm guessing, if I had to guess, he has 61 ratings at $9, but whatever. You guys get it. If you want to take a look at it, take a look. Link in description on how to bring products to market so that way you guys can solve the problem of everything. It doesn't matter what crash. You're like, whatever. I have my fishing pole. I got my boat. I got my family. It's, you know, life is good. But thank you guys so much for making it to the super tippy top very end. Hey, maybe think about it. Consider it. Subscribe to the channel so I can teach you how to start businesses, you know, and how crazy the world is. I want to help you guys. So you help me, I help you. Click the subscribe and I will see you tomorrow. Oh, also, Doug Casey, why wouldn't you want, you got to subscribe because then otherwise you forget. You don't get notified or whatever. And I don't even ask you to turn the bell notification on. All right. And then now you can go.